I have your attention, please. It's time for the final countdown. The show starts in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's rock.
Tune in to the Supreme Vibes Radio this and every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. for our new show, The Nightcap, with your host, Charlene Clark-Cure. Yes, our new show, The Nightcap, promises to be a scintillating show to heighten your relationship appetite. Come and join in the conversation, share your experience, and let us learn from each other. That's The Nightcap, this and every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. You do not want to miss the show. Tune in right here on the Supreme Vibes Radio, your radio station of choice.
Your choice for today's hottest hits and yesterday's favorites. Supreme Vibes Radio.
Zongo, zongo, go, zongo, zing. Zongo, zongo, go, zongo, zing. Hey, this is King Yellowman. And I'm in Dustin. Charlene Clark. King Yellowman said that. How you doing? Supporter. My people, my fans.
Inspirational Saturdays and Supreme Vibes Radio. You don't know seen with Charlene Clark, you don't know seen. 10 a.m. is turn. You don't know, quenchless, quenchless, until we turn.
Girl, you got smile so bright. At night, you don't need no light. Inspiration, ladies. Slide away, quenchless, quenchless. Big up, seen? Yeah, boom.
This is Major Mackerel, and you're listening to Charlene Clark. This is Major Mackerel, and you're listening to Charlene Clark. This is Major Mackerel, and you're listening to Charlene Clark.
Home and away, home and away, home and away, home and away. So me I send that one straight, straight from my heart, straight from my heart, straight from my heart. Charlene Clark, I send it straight, straight from her heart. Yeah, man, get alone, get alone, a little ear attack. You're listening to Charlene Clark and the Nightcap Show and Supreme Vibes Radio. Lock it. She got it.
Views and opinions expressed in this podcast are those of the author and guests to the show and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of the radio station. Assumptions made in the discussions are not reflective of the position of any entity other than the author and the guest, and since we are critically thinking human beings, these views are always subject to change, revision, and rethinking at any time. Please do not hold us to them in perpetuity.
Welcome, 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 listeners, to another episode of the Nightcap program with your host, yours truly, Charlene Clark-Cure. It's my pleasure to be here with you another Sunday. Yes, yes, yes. Before I begin, I want to do my due diligence. You know, I always have to do my due diligence. Yes. First, I must say welcome, 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 welcome to all my listeners on the SupremeVibesRadio.com. So, if you're joining me on the Supreme Vibes Radio, welcome to you. This is your radio station of choice. Also, welcome to my listeners and viewers on my YouTube channel, Designed to Inspire, with your girl, of course, you know who it is. Welcome and thank you for joining me. So I'm live on YouTube with this program for tonight. I also want to say to all the new listeners, welcome. We appreciate you. Thank you for joining, and we do hope that you will stick and stay. Before we commence, I'd like to thank you for making it the Supreme Vibes Radio, your radio station of choice, and also for joining me right here on my YouTube channel, Designed to Inspire with Charlene Clark-Cure. Do remember that the Supreme Vibes Radio continues to engage, motivate, and inspire you. also remember that we have live programs. We have, of course, yours truly with the Inspirational Saturdays show, and that show is aired 10 a.m. on Saturdays. We also have the sexy. Yes, every time I say that, I have to try to put on the sexy voice. Yes, I need to practice. I need to practice. My voice is too coarse, but let's see. Sexy. Yes, sexy with Nadia Alexandra. And we do have our live DJs in house. We have DJ Kurt, Bad From Birth, and he plays on Friday from 5 to 8 p.m. And he also plays on Saturdays from 8 to 10 p.m. We also have DJ Tyrical, Lyrical Tyrical, and he plays from 6 to 8 p.m. and also on Saturday at the same time. And DJ Beefy, yes, he plays on Friday from 8 to 10 p.m. and also on Sundays from 1 to 6 p.m. Do remember that the Supreme Vibes Radio is your radio station of choice, the place where you stay to be entertained, and I mean all the good things that you can think about. We talk about relationship, and then we talk about, you know, sexy with Nadia. She gives you some tips, you know, behind closed doors, what you can do. And of course, we play the music to entertain and engage you. And then we inspire you on a Saturday where we do our Inspirational Saturdays show. So let's start for tonight after this very short break.
Now this is Pat and Tony live and direct from Kingston, Jamaica, endorsing Supreme Vibes Radio. I don't know a big thing, yeah? Supreme Vibes is on your radio. Whoa, we're on your radio. Whoa, play the rubber dub style and the real reggae music. Supreme Vibes Radio, endorsed by I, Pat and Tony. Flash it.
I say Rastafari and I, please won't you hear me when I cry? Send down your angels just to save us. Blessed love, this is Dwayne Stevenson. You're listening to Supreme Vibe Radio. Same me, I say, don't change that dial.
Okay, my listeners, welcome. And to my viewers, I see you. Thank you for joining. Thank you for making it the Supreme Vibes Radio, those of you who are in Radioland. And for all my YouTube viewers, thank you for joining me right here on Design to Inspire with Charlene Clark Cure. Now, the Nightcap program, you're here to hear about, you know, I mean, relationship. And of course, this is the program that talks a little bit about relationship and how you can improve on your relationship and the things that you can do to, you know, make it better. Now, I want to continue. I call this part two, jealousy part two. Last week, my phone is already blowing up, viewers. My phone is already blowing up. But to the listener, or the viewer who just texted me, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Now, on one of my episode, Nightcap, I think it was episode 3. I believe it was episode 3. I spoke about jealousy, but jealousy in the sense where we wanted to understand why, you know, one would become jealous, or is it really, or is, does jealousy have a place in the relationship? Welcome, welcome. Does jealousy have a place in your relationship? Because we are of different views as it relates to relationship and how relationship should work and what should be included and what should be excluded. You know, it's what we like. Some people would say, well, a relationship without jealousy would mean that the man or the woman is not in love, while others may think that a relationship with jealousy simply means that either party is insecure. So remember that it's our opinion, and of course we share our opinion professionally. You don't have to agree with my opinion, and naturally I don't have to agree with yours, but we can have a discussion and come to we can bargain. But anyways, it's a discussion. So part two, I putting a little twist on it. Yes, a little twist on it. And I know it's going to be very engaging and mind-boggling. Do remember that you participate by, of course, for those of you who are on YouTube, Designed to Inspire with Charlene Clark Kuro, you can comment in the chat box, and of course I'll share your comment and I'll respond as much as I can. For those of you in Radio Land on the Supreme Vibes Radio, your radio station, of course, of choice, do remember that you can send me your WhatsApp message at 1-877-367-0127, or of course you can voice call me WhatsApp via WhatsApp, that is at 1-877-367-0127. So you can also share your opinion. Jealousy part two. I already somewhat explain what jealousy was in terms of a definition in part one, but part two, and this is where I'm getting at. I like to separate the males from the females because sometimes the conditions differ. Remember, and those of you who are joining the program for the first time, I would try to follow, right? Because it is always connecting. Now, I like to separate the males from the females because, you know, males and females operate differently as it relates to relationship, and thus I do not want to put them together. So, you know, I continue to do that, right? And so when I'm talking about jealousy part two tonight, what I'm looking at is there are many reasons why an individual will become jealous, right? And sometimes it's because of how we engage in a relationship, one. Sometimes, too, it's because of what that person didn't have in relationship in the past, too. And so we have to be cognizant of what we really want out of a relationship. Now, remember that you have different types of relationship, right? And I mean, during the intimate relationship, you still have different type. I'm not talking about platonic and that type of a thing. We're looking at intimacy. Intimate relationships, you still have different types of intimacy. What am I talking about? You do have those relationships where the individuals who are involved, or let me not say individuals, because oftentimes the condition is based on one person. Oftentimes the condition is based on one person's thinking, on one person's experience. So you might have a relationship where an individual decide that they're entering in this relationship because they just want to fill a gap for the moment. Then you have those relationships where the individual decide to enter in this particular relationship because at this moment it would be right for their career. Yes. Then you have those type of relationship now where an individual will enter into this particular relationship because it will allow them to get a green card. Yes, yes, I did say it. I'm sorry. Yes, I said it. I said it. But then you have different types of reasons why people enter in relationship. The only relationship that I, Charlene Clark Kuro, believes in is a relationship where you enter in because of love. That is the only relationship I believe will be lasting. Yes, it's not going to be perfect and there will be trials, but when you enter the relationship because you love the person, you genuinely love the person in good and in bad time, when the person look pretty and when the person look ugly, if there is anything such as ugly, because I don't see ugly, when the person is bad and when the person is good, you genuinely love the person, that's a relationship that will last and it is less stressful on you mentally and physically. I must make that clear. That's my disclaimer. That's the only relationship I believe in, right? Now, where am I going with this jealousy? Now, let's say you have a relationship, right, where the individual enters the relationship because of one of these reasons outside of love. They didn't enter because they love. Welcome, Veronica. They didn't enter because of love. They enter because of one of the reasons that I just stated. And the other party is unaware of that reason. Because guess what? Most of the times there exists selfishness. So I know that I'm entering the relationship because of a particular reason. Let's say I'm entering because I know this man can do the world for me, can open doors for me, and I'm entering, and at this moment in time, my career needs that. And so I'm entering the relationship right now because that is what I believe my career needs to, you know, to boom. However, in the back of my mind, I know that this is not the relationship I want. It's just for this particular reason. And so I enter in this relationship, but unbeknownst to the man, because I am not going to sit the man down and say, listen, sir, I'm entering the relationship with you because my career needs boosting, and you're the person who I believe can boost my career at this moment in time. And so as soon as I've stepped up the ladder and I've reached a particular place where I believe my career can exist without your help, I'm going to leave you. We don't do that. You know, we don't do that. What we do is enter in the relationship on false pretense. And of course, I did an episode on false pretender and relationship in the past as well. So we enter the relationship on false pretense based on what we have in our minds, based on our reasons, based on our modus operandi, right? And so the other party is always left in the dark as it relates to the reason. You know, and so many a times they are fooled that, okay, this person is in love with me, this person wants to share life with me, this person wants to share experiences with me. Of course I do, but only until my career reaches where I want it to reach. As soon as that is there, then I don't want to do anything else with you. No. And there lies the selfishness that I spoke about. You know, we enter and we have our reasons, we have our modus operandi. We don't share it with the other person. It's selfish because, let's say, put it on the table and say, well, then listen, I'm going to you like me, I kind of okay with you, but I'm going to tell you, if I enter in the relationship, it's for this reason. Let the person decide that, yes, them can work with it. Yes, you hear that? Yes, them can work with it. That's my dialect coming out. Right. So let the person decide that, yes, they are okay with it. You know, it's fine by them. But do not enter without, you know, having that discourse. It's hard because we are not genuine beings, so to speak. We prefer, and again I say this because I mean it's a truth. It's a truth. We prefer to sugarcoat. We prefer to hide our feelings. We prefer to hide our reasons. We prefer to do those things, right? And so the other party would not know. All right. So if you are entering a relationship, and this is for, let me see, who do I start with? Let's start with the females. If you recognize, and is it right? It's not for me to tell you if it's wrong or right. My morals, my values are different from your morals and your values. I can't say to you this is wrong or this is right. I can give you my opinion, and that's why I stated my disclaimer at the beginning. You should know what works for you. So I'm not about to judge right now. I'm not judgmental, never was, never will be. But what I'm saying is let the person know. So females, let's say you enter in a relationship for any reason apart from love, and you know that at the moment when you would have arrived, and when I say arrived, let's say this person would be able to, I mean, facilitate your tuition. You're studying your master's or PhD, and this person is able to assist you financially, and that's just what you want. And you decide that the person really likes you, and you recognize that he's able, he's capable. And so because you know that the person really likes you, you play upon that, you enter in the relationship. You know that it takes, what, 3-4 years for a master's. It depends on what type of PhD, you know, however long it takes. And you in the back of your head decide that, listen, as soon as I'm done, I'm gone. Right? Let's say you enter the relationship as such. The mistake the mistake that you do is You enter the relationship with false pretense. However, all the good things that you would bring to a relationship that is meaningful and that should be for love, you take into this relationship that you really, really, really don't want. Did I confuse you? Let me clarify. You enter the relationship knowing that you just want, and I'm just using this as an example. You enter the relationship knowing that this person likes you, this person is capable of financing your education, to, you know, and so you're going to use that opportunity because he likes you, yes, and he's able to finance your education because you want to go further, but you're just not financially stable. And so you enter the relationship on that false pretense. However, you are an individual who, you know, you have the skills. What skills am I talking about? Yes, I'm talking about that skills too, because I can see the smiles and my phone is going off. Yes. And yes, I'm talking about that skill too, but I'm talking about you enter with all the skills that you have, right? Because guess what? You want to fool him so badly so that him stay for the 4 years or the 3 years or the 6 years. You know, you don't want him to leave before you complete your PhD or your master's or whatever. Right? So you enter with all the skills that you have and use the skills to fool him. So if you can cook, if you're a good cook, you're going to enter the relationship preparing the best meal ever. Yes? Preparing the best dishes ever. Right? If you are a person who is sociable, if you are a person who, you know, you are caring, you are loving, you lend a listening ear and then some, you enter the relationship as such. And then in the bedroom, same thing. In the bedroom, you enter the relationship and you give him every single ounce of you, top to bottom, middle side, every single ounce. And you're spontaneous. You introduce stuff in the bedroom because, listen, you're doing all that you can do to keep this man with you until your degree has come to an end, until your study has come to an end. So you're doing all that you can do to keep him in your corner. And he's there thinking in his head, because you didn't have that discussion with him before to say, well, then, you know, you like me? All right. Since you like me, well, something for something. Right? That's how we say it in Jamaica. Something for something. Right? So if you like me, let's barter here. Let's bargain. So if you like me, I'm not so much into you, but if you like me enough, I want to finish my studies. I will sleep with you. I will live with you. But as soon as that is done, it's going to take 3 years. Are you okay with 3 years for us to be together? Because after the 3 years, I'm going, you know? So if you want us to... Let him make the decision, right? Let him make the decision that, yes, he's okay to stay for the 3 years, but we don't do that. And so you enter the relationship and you do everything, right? Family gatherings, you're there and you're having the nice discussions and your face is beautiful and you put yourself together, right? And so the man is falling more and more and more in love with you, right? In the back of your head, you're like, yes. Let him stay there. All I want is to finish this degree and then go about my business. So whatever it takes, I'm going to do, and then I'm going to go about my business. And when you're talking to your friends, your you know, he becomes a joke, you know? Yes, you know, yesterday I cooked the best stew peas ever. I cooked the best stew peas ever, and he enjoyed it because I have to do all that I can do to keep him. Because I need to finish this study, and he's the one who is going to pay for it. So he's been fooled. He's in my corner. Have him in my corner. You know, he becomes a joke when you talk to your friends. However, when he's talking about you, you're his wife. Yes, he's now planning the engagement party while you're planning your exit party, right? And so when we do that, when that is done, what you find is that jealousy can come into play there. Yes? Because put it this way, when you show a man what the love and the care, the energy, you know, the skills that you have, all skills, listeners and viewers, all skills that you have, when you show a man that, he is not going to want to let go. And so when you begin to try to detach yourself, what you find, as a matter of fact, before the detachment, what you will find is that he's jealousy might come into play, and he might not want you to go certain place, he might not want you to do certain things or to say certain things, you know, that sort of jealousy. And so when you are ready to detach yourself, to cut the umbilical cord, yes, when you're ready to detach yourself, what you find is that the jealousy is no more pronounced, because you have now showed the man what you are capable of, what he can get, and this is all that he desire, because you did so, because in the back of your mind, if you did anything less, you might run the risk of losing him and dropping out of school. And so you enter the relationship with all of these skills and everything that you love and everything that you can do, and you're involved in everything just to ensure that graduation day you will be walking up to the podium to collect your degree. And the poor man is there thinking about, okay, after the graduation, I am going to get down on one knee and I am going to propose. And so jealousy, a man can become jealous because of what you show him, what you give him, what you do for him, right? And it's not easy to find. Believe me, it's not easy to find. I will return after this very short break because, I mean, I want to now talk to the men, and I want to also tell you, I'm not even sure if this is right for me to tell you what to do, but especially something that I don't really believe in. I don't believe that people should enter relationship on false pretense. I really don't believe that, right? I think it is, but then again, for me, my morals, my values are different from yours. My reasons, your reasons are completely different, and people live their lives. And so if this is something that an individual wants to do, what I want to do is to say, do it right. And when I return, I'll be speaking with the men, and then of course I'll be talking about doing it right. Don't go and cook, right, the best meal ever if you know that you don't want the man. A man really likes his belly, and when a woman can prepare a good meal for him, he is completely in love. He's completely in love. Viewers, listeners, please stick and stay. Go nowhere. I will be taking my very first break. And when I return, I'll speak to the men as it relates to jealousy and relationship.
You tell us in a stick. That little bit of can't cook.
I'm on my way. So me I send that one straight, straight from my heart, straight from my heart, straight from my heart. Charlene Clark, I send it straight, straight from her heart. Yeah, man, get alone, not alone, a little ear attack. You're listening to Charlene Clark on the Nightcap Show on Supreme Vibes Radio. Lock it. She got it.
Flush it. That just sound right for it. Welcome back and thank you for sticking and staying right here on the Supreme Vibes Radio, your radio station of choice. And thank you for joining me on the YouTube channel Designed to Inspire with Charlene Clark Cure. Let us continue. Do remember to participate. You can WhatsApp me at 1-877-367-0127. You can also voice call me WhatsApp via WhatsApp at the same number, 1-877-367-0127. Now, it's kind of similar from men as it relates to entering into a relationship when you are not desirous of being in the relationship long term. Now, the difference is, and some time ago in previous program, I spoke about the fact that men and women engage in relationship differently as it relates to feelings. A woman after, you know, entering in a relationship, she enters with her heart. A man will enter a relationship based on how the woman look, and then he enters the relationship just to, you know, get an idea as to how the woman feels, and that's fine by him. So you see, now we are in a different kind of world. Gone were the days, listeners and viewers, when men used to be the ones who decide to take care of the woman holistically, protect her, provide for her, care for her. And so gone were the days when a man would refuse financial gains, you know, outside of the fact that when you're in a relationship, it's not about what I have and what you have. If you're in a relationship of such and you find that it's what about I have, what about you have, it means that you're not really ready for that particular relationship. When you're in a relationship, it should be us in terms of what both of us have and how we can build together to grow. But gone were the days when a man would decide that no, he is the man in the relationship, and so it is his responsibility to care for the woman financially, emotionally, physically, because, you know, sometimes he would have to lift her up. But gone were those days, because what is happening now, and I say this, what is happening now is men are, I don't know, we're losing our men. Every platform, every time I get the opportunity to say this, I have to say it because it is real, it is natural. We are losing our men to all manner of things. And so now what you will find, just as how you will find a woman entering a relationship on false pretense because she wants to complete her degree, you will have a man doing the same thing. No, I mean, I said it with as though it is surprising, and it is really not. You will have a man who will do the same thing. He will enter the relationship because he has certain things that he wants to cover, and so he believes that being in this relationship with this particular woman will financially help him to, you know, jump over that hurdle. You do have that, and that happens now more frequently than even before, right? And I had to start it like that because it's somewhat sad. Well, it's sad for both, but it's somewhat sad because I believe I'm from the old school. Yes, I really don't have the gray hair and all those things happening as yet, but I'm from the old school. I do believe that the man is the dominant person in the relationship, should be the dominant person in the relationship, and the woman should step back and let the man lead. I don't believe in equality for men and women because I don't think that is possible. God made man stronger for a particular reason. season, and I will allow my man to lead, to direct. Of course, there are moments when both of us will sit down and decide together, but he's supposed to take the handle. Not that I can't, because I can, but I know my place as a woman. And as I said, I am from the old school. I do believe that a man should be the head of the home. It doesn't matter if he's earning less. He should be the head of the home. The woman should be the caregiver, the nurturer, right? And so because of some of these principles, and maybe I'm moving off in a tangent, but this need to be said, because many of us as females are losing some of that type of principle. You find that we are having children who are confused or who are not really nurtured the proper way because we are not caring enough for them. We are thinking that, okay, we have to, you know, equalize ourselves with the man, and so we're doing then some and more to, you know, to compete somewhat with the man because we want to show that we are strong too. No, that's, I don't believe in that at all. So I had to make that disclaimer as well. However, I have to be neutral. And so you do have men who also enter in a relationship because they have certain financial responsibilities that they want assistance with, and they're not going to, sometimes they're not going to come out and say, well, then I want you to pay my tuition, I want you to help me build my house, or I want you to buy me a Range Rover, or whatever the situation is. They might use the opportunity to know that this woman likes them for whatever reason, and so they enter into the relationship that in this way, all right? And so it is still on false pretense. So for the men, it is similar in terms of how you enter the relationship where jealousy is concerned, right? And so you enter the relationship because you have your modus operandi as a man as well. And so you enter with false pretense to hope that this woman will help you fulfill your responsibility, fulfill your needs as it relates to whatever it is, whatever plans or goals you have for yourself. You really don't like the individual, right? It's practically the same thing, whether it's for a career goal or green card or, you know, a financial something, right? Whether it is that you think that she can help you with a home or whatever the situation is, help you with your career because she has societal standing and you need that to boost your career, that type of a thing. And so you know that she has a liking for you and you enter the relationship. And it's the same thing. You enter the relationship knowing that you are not interested in staying with this individual, and you enter being nice. No, it's opposite, where you're not going to be able to facilitate the financial, maybe she doesn't really need that because of her standing, but you're not going to able to facilitate her financial needs. But what you do to compensate for that is to ensure that, you know, you keep a good house, you are a good listener, right? You would follow her to the hair salon because men don't like to do that when, you know, follow their ladies to the hair salon because that takes a day and a night. You will take her grocery shopping and you would be patient. So what you do is to increase their patience level. You do some things extra that usually a man don't really have. A man would have to work hard. A man would have to work hard to get there. So you do some things extra to increase their patience. Hi, Stephen Kuro. Welcome. And also I must say welcome to one of our new listeners on the Supreme Vibes Radio. That person is from Ecuador. I see you. I appreciate you. Thank you. And I hope you will stick and stay. Welcome. And of course, tell all your friends and family members in Ecuador about the Supreme Vibes Radio. Of course, thank you for joining. We appreciate you. Welcome. Now, you enter the relationship, and so you do the extra that women would complain that they don't find in a man. What does women talk about? What we talk about most of the time, yes. What do we talk about most of the times when we do talk? You know, the man is not listening. The man doesn't want to help to take care of the home. He is not caring. He's not willing to take to carry my handbag, you know, however trivial it might sound, but we talk about those things. And do you believe the men don't know? They know. They know these things. They know, right? And so you'll find now a man who is entering the relationship because of his modus operandi, his reason, will enter the relationship now and do these things that women talk about that are usually absent in a relationship. And so he amplifies this. And so he is the best listener ever. He is the best lover ever. It's not that after, you know, you would have, you know, made love, he's gone to sleep. Even if he wants to sleep, he's going to keep his eyes open and he's going to listen to you and he's going to cuddle, because he has to do these things extra so that he can get what he wants from you. What is happening there though? What is really happening is that by doing this, because these are the things that women want, right? These are the things that women need, N-E-E-D, all in caps. The woman is now falling in love, well, standing in love, right? The woman is becoming more and more in love with this man. Right? No, she's not thinking about the day when she's going on her knee to propose. She's thinking about how soon will he go on his knee to propose to her. And so 2 years after, she's thinking, but she's unable to detach herself because this man is so nice. This man is so beautiful, if you have that. This man is so handsome, not his physical handsomeness, but his attitude, his action in the relationship. And so she can't really let go of that. 5 years after, when she's talking to her girlfriends about, oh, my boo. And, you know, I don't know when, but he treats me so nice. I know the day is going to come when he's going to ask me to marry him. 10 years after, she's singing the same song. Now she's getting older. The limbs are getting tired. The knees are getting weak. And she's still there waiting. Well, 10 years, the man's career now is where he wants it to be. And he's now planning his exit path. That's sad. And so what will happen now? Jealousy can now come into play, right? So there are many reasons why people are jealous. And, you know, sometimes when you find that your partner is over, I don't know, you tell me, 1-877-367-0127 via WhatsApp or right here in the chat, you tell me. Sometimes when our partners are jealous, do you ever do some self-retrospection to see if you're the reason for the jealousy? Because sometimes it is, you know, sometimes it is. And if you realize or recognize that you're the reason, how do you handle that? That sounds like a different program that I could, you know, have. How do you handle that? But when you are, and this is the fix, when you are entering a relationship, and you know for a fact that you're entering the relationship because you want to fulfill a need that is void, and this person will help you to fill the need. Again, let me put my disclaimer out for persons who are just joining. I do not believe an individual should enter in the relationship to use a person, but my morals, my values are different from yours, and each person live their life accordingly. Now, if you enter a relationship because you feel that this person will be able to assist you to fill a void in your relationship, do not give off yourself completely and do not, I understand the reason behind that, because you want to keep the person until the void is filled. However, do know that you're further hurting the person. You're causing further damage and pain. So you want to control what you're going to give, what you're going to do, how you're going to engage. Do not go and meet the mother do not go in the family and become a staple in the family, because you are causing further damage and pain. Because once you make the individual, and I'm talking to both genders now, once you make the individual comfortable and happy, do know most times the family members are going to like you, are going to appreciate you, because family members always like for their family to be happy. Right? So it could be a child, an aunt, an uncle, you know, they like the individual to be happy. And when they recognize that this person is experiencing happiness through this partner, through this person, they too are going to like you. If you know that you have an exit plan, do not engage the individual in a holistic way and then break so many hearts when you start traveling on your exit path. You know, some people are so good at pretending. You cannot, there's not a moment or a day where you can tap into the pretense and say, well, then I see what this person is doing. Some people are so good at pretending. And so then jealousy comes into play. And then when jealousy comes into play, then you have various type of actions behind it. Because the person now becomes jealous and decide that, listen, I can't lose you. I don't want to lose you. Please don't go. And if they feel, depending on the type of individual that he or she is, if they feel as though their back is against the wall, they might engage in some activity where you might lose your life, or you might be disfigured, or something of the sort, though wrong. So we have to be careful how we engage and entertain as it relates to relationship. You see, or... They said that the flesh is weak. I'm not sure if that is true. I think the mind is stronger. And so if you from your mind here decide that you're going to tell yourself what to do, there's no way your flesh can lead you, right? However, if they say the flesh is weak, you have to ensure that when you're weakened by somebody because of their flesh, you know exactly what you're doing. I take my final break. Remember, when I return, you can participate. I have someone who is ready to participate already. Let's hear from him when I return. Please, stick and stay. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back to continue on this topic.
Jealous of the rain.
staying. Thank you for joining. Thank you. And as we wrap up tonight's show, I hope you were entertained. I hope you liked the show. I hope I brought some clarity somewhat as it relates to a different perspective on jealousy. Now, I have some comments here from some of my listeners. This person is, yes, in Florida, and he says, "Thank you. I've always been listening to your show. It's very informative. However, jealousy is a sin." Yes, it's going off. Jealousy is a sin, full stop, nothing else. I'm not quite sure what you mean by that. Jealousy is a sin, but like I said, to each his own. And your opinion is your opinion. Listener, if you are still on, please explain to me what you mean when you say that jealousy is a sin. What really do you mean by that? I hope you will come and explain. I have another listener here who texted in and said, "Charlene, people need to stop using people. It hurts, and a lot of people get hurt along the way." Yes, I believe this person is from Chicago. Yes, Chicago. Now, to all my listeners in Chicago, thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you for joining. Thank you for making it the Supreme Vibes Radio, your radio station of choice. Yes, oh yes. To be hurting persons, knowing that you don't want to be with them, knowing that you're using them, is not something that, you know, sits well with me, right? And it's painful. And like this listener said, a lot of people get hurt along the way because of this action. Let me go to another comment. This person says, okay, hold on, let me get there. Okay, so this person says, females are usually, hi Charlene, thank you for always engaging and entertaining, right? Females are usually the persons or the ones who always deceive in a relationship. They seem to have the heart or the know-how of how to deceive their partner. What do I say about that? It's not personal. I'm getting a call right now. Let's see. Welcome to the Supreme Vibes Radio. You're listening to Charlene Clark and the Nightcap program. Please state your name and where you're from.
Hey, I'm Layton. I'm from New Jersey.
Hi, Layton from New Jersey. You are one of the regular listeners. Now, let me hear from your perspective. Do you believe that jealousy could be born out of the fact that individuals enter the relationship without being real? And also they use the individual to reach their goal and then make their exit. What is your view on that?
Yeah, well, a lot of folks get jealous for a lot of different reasons. Sometimes some jealousy is real. Sometimes some jealousy is selfish, like, you know, you have a person, you're using them, and you want to, like, keep them for yourself. You want to, like, lock them down a certain way. Not that you genuinely care about what they do or who they talk to or anything like that, but you just want to use them and use them 100%. You just, like, lock them to yourself. But, and then, there's a lot of folks that enter a relationship genuinely knowing that they don't want the person, but they enter the relationship based on what they can get out of the relationship or what they set up in the beginning, in the initial stage to get where mm-hmm. or for money, you know.
Mm-hmm.
A particular person may have a certain amount of money or own vehicle or whatever, and you know, you just start a relationship with that person just for that reason, no?
Okay.
You have a car you can drive, you have a house you can stay in for a while, whatever it may be.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Go ahead, sorry, listener, go ahead.
So a lot of folks out there is living in false hope. Just last night, this person was sharing with me, like, you know, he drives Lyft, and I was talking, and he said, "It's all like you're from an island." And I said, "Yeah, I am from Jamaica." And, you know, I was like, "Yeah, Jamaica, my people, my whatever. He's a Puerto Rican, and he was saying that he used to talk to this Jamaican lady for 4 years,
mm-hmm.
but the lady deceived him.
For 4 years?
The lady, she has, her boyfriend was in prison,
mm-hmm.
but the boyfriend was supposed to come out at a certain time, so she used him for that particular time. Crook called it nice. It was like, "Yo, she made me love this rice and peas and hot mm-hmm. steel and cricket mm-hmm. and cricket." He did all the things that, you know, a woman should do for a man.
Right.
And he said he almost got married to her. Almost.
You hear that, listeners?
Mm-hmm. Just before the marriage, the man came out of prison.
Wow.
As the man came out, she like whoops
mm-hmm.
and disappear.
Wow.
But then he said that the man ended up go back to prison and went back to spend life
wow.
in prison.
That's what you call karma.
And he happened to meet her up again, mm-hmm. see her again, and she was like, "Yo, we can get back in a relationship." And he said all the things that she was refusing to give him before,
mm-hmm.
he get it and more. Well, he said he took the opportunity, but in terms of having a relationship and getting married, he just ran.
Right. So he kind of flipped the script on her, where he now became the user.
Exactly.
Okay.
So there's a lot of people out there that is living false hope even now, right?
Mm-hmm.
No?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people are living false hope. They have this dream of getting married, having a family, but that's in the mind of one person, but in the mind of the other,
mm-hmm.
nothing like that will ever happen.
Mm-hmm.
But they do pretend like it will happen. They do give you hope that it will happen, but in reality, it will never happen because that's not their plans.
Mm-hmm.
They have other plans. Mm-hmm. I mean,
yeah.
Just like people wanting to get overseas, people wanting to get to Jamaica, because you know, people in other countries want to go to Jamaica, want citizenship in Jamaica, so they develop relationships
mm-hmm.
that aren't real just to get what they want.
Right.
So one has to be very careful when entering a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
They have to be very careful of the foundation that relationship is built upon.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they are not careful, they will be deceived and they will be hurt and hurt miserably.
Thank you so very much. But how can one be careful? Before you go, listener, you said that one has to be very careful. How can you be careful so that you don't end up in this kind of mess?
A lot of times there are warning signs. A lot of time along the way, you get signals
mm-hmm.
that this is not going the way you want it to go, because at the get-go, at the very beginning, you dive all
the way in.
You put mm-hmm. all your energy, all your attention, everything in it, in the fruit of it, without even considering warning signs or the hints that you're getting that this will not go the way you want it to go.
Okay.
So a lot of time we can deceive ourselves
mm-hmm.
by diving too deep
mm-hmm.
without testing the surface of the water. So it's like, yeah, we just dive in the water and gone to the bottom, when really on top of the water it's just oil. It's a big oil spill.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? With that oil spill, us being under the bottom of the water, that oil spill will like cause some negative effect on us and probably stifle or something
mm-hmm.
from the fumes of the oil.
Right.
But
yeah, very, thank you so very much. You know, listener, you can introduce your friend, your Puerto Rican friend, to the Supreme Vibes Radio and, you know, my YouTube channel, Designed to Inspire, and find out if he would like to share his story, you know, if he would like to share his story on this platform, we will welcome him. But thank you for your participation, and yes, we just need to be careful, but how careful is careful? To Layton out there, thank you so very much, Layton. Thank you. To Layton out there in New Jersey, thank you for participating. And to all my listeners in New Jersey, thank you for listening. Thank you for making it the Supreme Vibes Radio, your radio station of choice. To all my viewers, thank you for making it the Design to Inspire right here on YouTube. Now, Andrea Dallos, I can see she commented in the chat and she said that jealousy can be very dangerous. Yes, we know that. We know that jealousy can be very dangerous, because when an individual is jealous, there is no way to tell what that person will do. And sometimes you don't stop to think. You act, and then after the action, then you begin to think, and then, you know, you begin to wonder if what you did was right, sometimes if you can correct it, or then you begin to prepare for prison. Thank you, Andrea Dallas. Thank you. It's my pleasure. And to all my listeners out there in radio land, thank you for joining. Now, listeners, we have come to the end of this show. Let me see just one. Okay. So we've come to the end of the show, the Supreme Vibes Radio Nightcap program with yours truly, Charlene Clark Cura. Now, I must say to you, do remember that this Thursday is Memories Thursday, where I will be spinning it on the turntable. Yes, I'll be playing some music for you this Thursday at 6 p.m. I think it's from 6 to 8. Yes, and then again we will have the sexty. Oh, I just did not say that right. Sexty with Nadia Alexandra. Sexty. I will practice the sexy voice. Yes, so we have sexty on Friday. We have sexty on Friday, and that show, and on Friday and Saturday, and that program is aired 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. And then on Saturday, this Saturday, do not, listeners, viewers, do not miss this Saturday's inspirational show. It is going to be lit. I'll be speaking with a young lady who has experienced sexual abuse, who has experienced racism, who is now working on projects involving human trafficking. This person will be talking to me this Saturday on the Supreme Vibes Radio. And of course, you can get access to this information on my YouTube channel. We will upload the video. Please do not miss this Saturday's inspirational show with yours truly, which will be aired promptly at 10 a.m. So this Saturday, please set your clocks, set your timer for the inspirational show. It's going to be very informative. It's going to really open your eyes to what is really happening around us, because some of us are very naive and, you know, vulnerable. So let's not miss this Saturday show. And then, of course, you have live music right here on the Supreme Vibes Radio. Please, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do so now. Take the opportunity to subscribe as I continue to inspire, motivate, and engage. And those persons who have not yet downloaded the app for the Supreme Vibes, do so now, or you can also access the programs from the supremevibesradio.com. Listeners, this is where I take my leave. I say goodbye. Until then, I'll see you right here on the Supreme Vibes Radio, or right here on Design to Inspire, my YouTube channel, where we will have another Nightcap program talking about real topics, real issue, engaging real people, and then we share together. Do remember too, if you have a story and would like to share the story, reach out to me, and of course we will use this platform to share your story in order to motivate other persons. Thank you, I appreciate you. Until then, relax and listen some music right here on the Supreme Vibes Radio. Viewers, thank you. See you soon this Saturday. Do not miss my show. It was my pleasure being here with you.